All right, so don't forget, tomorrow we'll be having the Lagos preliminary draw where 32 schools will be taking part, and they will know how they have to play to pick out the Lagos representatives for the national final that will be taking place next year. So we expect the schools, they've already been communicated, we expect them to be around on time to be a part of that draw. Let's come to Sunshine now, and I'm sure that the cap right there, our cameras can pick it, so that maybe we can also help Sunshine to shine brighter than they are doing at the moment. But I want to bring to your notice Sonny Young. I'm sure you've seen Sonny Young so many times. He's a fan of Sunshine Stars. I'm sure Sonny Young is not happy that Sunshine are hovering around the relegation area, relegation zone.
Right, the league is a marathon.
Okay,
it's a long distance race. Yes. So I'm positive that our fans and supporters across the country and beyond will still have cause to smile at the end of the day.
But what's the problem? What's going on with Sunshine? It's opposite of what we had last season. Last season, Sunshine Stars hit the ground running, and I think for the entire four stands, they were almost 3-4 points clear at the top. It's a different approach now. This season, you are struggling to warm up, and we're already week 11.
Well, some of the boys, the players that made the team tick last year, left at the end of the season. You talk of the likes of Paul Unobi, the likes
Agri.
Of Prince Agri, you know, this guy now playing for Ifeanyi Ubah, this Cameroonian.
Tammy Medrano.
Exactly. So a lot of the boys left. And of course, it means that we had to start building a new team, that is, bringing in new players to join hands with those left on ground. You know, that takes quite some time. So we had that teething problem from the beginning. And of course, also, I think the technical crew initially did not get it right. And of course, we had to do a bit of adjustment here and there. And so starting from week five or thereabout, we changed the technical crew. And for now, you realize that things are looking up brighter. In the last four games, you know, we've not lost. We are on four matches unbeaten run.
Oh,
now.
Good.
We were in Port Harcourt. We played against the combination of Dolphin and Sharks.
You played Rivers United.
Exactly, Rivers United. So it was goalless.
Yeah.
Then we came back home and gave it to shooting, you know, 2-1. And of course,
and then you went to Lokoja.
From there, we went to Lokoja.
Tornadoes.
Tornadoes. It was, in fact, the first us to a 2-2 draw. And then from Lokoja, we journeyed all the way to Lagos City, Lagos. And it was goalless.
They were almost going to win. That was the penalty.
Well, that last minute penalty.
That penalty, if we had gone in.
God decided to be on the side of Ondo State. Maybe for the sake of my governor, for my humble self, or the teaming, you know, masses of Ondo State. And the supporters of the club across the country. So that shot, you know, was ballooned over the bar. So they wasted it.
So how long are you going to stay unbeaten?
As long as God wants. And as long as long as the team continues to get it right. You know, our new technical advisor, that's Solomon Ogbeide.
He's been there before.
He's been there before. He took the team to the continent. So he's back now. And we are
and
expecting
four
him
games unbeaten now.
To make it a brace. Yeah, four games unbeaten. So we expect that to be, you know, continuous. We expect that to be on.
But what tell us the story of Henry Abiodun and Samson Onuanel. You didn't give them enough time. A lot of people believe that you didn't give them enough time on the job. After just about two games or three games, you fired the coach.
Maybe we would have given them more time. We did not actually fire them like that.
Okay.
We asked them to step aside. We
asked them step aside in Nigeria. People don't step back in.
We asked them to step aside. You see, we would have given them more time.
Okay.
If we had seen that they were ready to work together to achieve results. But we discovered that they were not really working
together
in tandem. They were not working together. We are not doubting their credentials as coaches. That was not the issue at stake. The issue at stake was that when someone was pulling the boat to the right, the other pulling to the left, There was no way we could allow that.
The management should have told them, this is the man in charge, this is the man that is second in command, so that there will be some kind of order.
On two different occasions, I brought them together
okay.
in a peace move. But they did not allow, that to work.
Mm.
And you see, there is this Yoruba proverb that the eyes that will see you to the evening will not begin to
have problems in the morning.
Oh, yes. And so
you started seeing the problems early in the morning.
Of course. You should take a long distance shot.
Mm.
Mm? This other proverb, that when you don't want a long stick to hit you from a long distance,
you duck
you
from
try
a long
doing
way.
The dodging and ducking. So that was exactly what we did. We already saw the problem building up. And from all observations and from all indications, it was like there was not going to be any change. There was not going to be any improvement. At the moment we brought in a new team, by way of technical crew, you see that the changes are already there. And let me also tell you, our position on the lockdown may be a bit deceitful. The truth of the matter is that we played 9 matches, only three of them at home, and 6 away. The 3 matches at home, yes, we played 2 draws, no big deal, and 1 win.
Mm.
The 6 away matches, we've drawn 3 and lost 3. We are number 18 on the log. We have 2 outstanding matches at home.
Which, if you win, could move you up.
Yeah, of course, not could, but would.
But you have to win those games before you start to count those points.
We are not counting the points.
Mm.
We are counting on the points.
Okay.
Yes, we are counting on the points. And by His grace, of course, the points will come.
Mm.
And of course, by our deed of hard work. So, if we consider the fact that we played 6 away matches, more away matches than most teams in Nigeria, and, we have 2 outstanding matches, basically, I'm almost sure, almost confident, that at the end of round 1, after 19 matches, we won't be where we are now.
Mm.
We won't be where we are now.
Okay. Toby is a sunshine. Let me warn you that Toby is a shooting star supporter. And, Toby, you have
On this part,
You are sunshine?
No, on this part.
You are neutral?
Yeah, I'm neutral. Okay. Chairman, I really want to ask some key questions, some problems you inherited last season. Firstly, welfare of players, how are you working on that? And secondly, is the issue with your fans. These are 2 issues you inherited.
Fans,
how are you trying to curb these 2 issues? Welfare of the players and then
the attitude
issues,
of the fans.
Attitude of your fans.
Let me first of all address the issue of the fans. Before the commencement of the league, we sponsored the state FA to organize a stakeholder seminar.
Mm.
Whereby everybody was told about the do's and don'ts of the league, what to do on match days, what to avoid, what not to do, and so on. And it's actually working. Because for a venue like Akure, if you look at what happened at the beginning of the league, our very first home match ended in a draw. And then we went out there to Bakodi and lost 2-1.
Mm.
We came back home, we played another draw with Ifeanyi Uba.
Yep.
There was no problem. There was no problem. Everyone was peaceful.
But the problem against your regional rival?
Your Southwest brothers.
Exactly.
Your
you are getting it right.
Yeah.
So, the problem against our regional rivals. You see, I don't know what it is.
We are supposed to be brothers. Why is it that
we're brothers?
Shooting stars,
someone like me grew up supporting 3SC. Mm. I mean, you all know that. But when it comes to 3SC, Shooting Stars, and Sunshine Stars, it's always a problem. At Akure, it will be a problem. At Ibadan, it will be a problem. So we have already, spoken to the authorities, the authorities of football in Nigeria, that something has to be done. We have appealed to some stakeholders in the Southwest, the chairman of the FAs in the 6 states, and some other elderly stakeholders around the area, that they have to come in. And we, on our part, we are ready for peace. What happens when the 2 teams plays at Ibadan and Akure are nothing to be proud of, nothing to write home about. And I think if we go into it without pretensions, without, we can get it right.
Yep.
We can get it right.
I was talking
about the fans. So if we play 2 home draws and there was no problem, that shows discipline.
Mm.
That shows control. And then we also lost three matches in a row, you know, away from home. So we came back. The fans still received us very well. So what happened at Akure, the day Shooting Stars came, happens to be part of the age-long problem.
Rivalry.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, what about the welfare of the players? You know, some problems.
About the welfare of the players, when we came on board, of course, the players were being owed some salaries, about 3 months for Sunshine Stars, about 4 months for Sunshine Queen. And then Sunshine Stars were all the 6 matches winning bonuses from last season, amounting to about 7.6 million. Of course, we cleared all these arrears. Here I must say that my governor, the sports-loving governor of Ondo State,